Welcome, kids, moms, and dads. We're so blessed to see you and spend time together as we gather around to enjoy our Kids Church family experience and learn more about our great God. Thank you for making us a part of your weekend. My name is Viv Stone, and I'm the Kids Church pastor here at Christian Assembly Church. Welcome, welcome. Hey, kids, I love our weekly interviews, the Zoom meetings, even our Kids Church videos that have showcased you and allow us to see all the amazing gifts and talents God has given you. Some of you sing so beautifully or play instruments. Some of you are great at art and creativity or science, math, and history. We're going to learn about making the most of what we've been given, and our young'uns will be learning about God's greatness over nature. So let's get on with our video. Enjoy and share. Are you ready? Here we go.
Hi, Kids Church. It is time for one of my favorite things. It's time for Kid Interview. And today I'm super excited to introduce you to Elena. Elena, you want to say hi to Kids Church?
Hi.
We're so excited that you said yes and that we get to know you a little bit better. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to get right into it. Start off really easy breezy. How old are you? When's your birthday?
I'm 8-9.
When's your birthday? And
my birthday is March 22nd.
And what grade are you in?
I'm in fourth grade.
Fourth grade. How do you like fourth grade?
I like it pretty good, but I also have a new teacher.
Oh, you do? How's that going?
Very good.
Good. I'm so glad. Elena, would you show us a favorite thing, or at least something you love, in your room?
My favorite thing in my room is my stuffed animals. I call them my stuffed animal collection. Okay. Here they are.
Oh, look. How many are there? Do you know?
Nope.
Are those lights behind? What are your stuffed animals in front of? What is that?
Oh, that's my stained glass. And behind that, there's my Christmas tree.
I love it. I love the stained glass. And then the way that the Christmas tree is like making that light up. That is so pretty. Okay. Could you pick a favorite stuffed animal? Would that even be possible?
Oh, I have my favorite stuffed animal. Definitely.
Please introduce us.
This is Midnight.
Ooh, look how cute. Okay, so we've been spending a little bit more time at home, right?
Yes.
What is something that you have been enjoying about being at home? What do you enjoy?
Well, I get to see my family more, definitely.
Okay, and that's a good thing. Do you have any siblings?
Yes, I have two brothers.
What do you guys enjoy? What do you enjoy doing with your family?
I mostly enjoy playing more board games. I like Phase 10 and something called Guess Who and chess.
Ooh, nice. If I were to ask you three words to best describe yourself, what three words would you use?
Well, this one isn't exactly a word. It's two words. It's dragon lover, caring, and lizard catcher. I catch a lot of lizards.
Dragon lover, caring, lizard catcher.
Yes.
I love it. If you could have any superpower, what superpower would you want to have and why?
Turning into any animal in the world so that I could see, like, the world from that animal's point of view.
Ooh, that's nice. So you would want to mix it up, like different animals. What one would you want to be first?
Oh, that's so hard. I would probably want to be something that flies so I could fly.
Yes, that's so good. I love that. All right, you've definitely got some time, but I'm wondering, do you have any thoughts about what you would like to be when you grow up?
Yes, I actually have three.
Ooh,
so
tell us.
I would like to be a zookeeper, a book writer, and or a mom.
Okay. What about all three?
No.
Okay.
One of them.
Just one of them. All right. Well, I look forward to seeing which one. I think that's great. If you could share anything with Kids Church just to encourage us, what would you want to share with us?
I would want to share that Kids Church, even though this is a hard time, keep trusting in God.
Yes, I love that. Did you hear that, Kids Church? Right from Elena's mouth. You got to keep trusting God. I love it. Thank you so much. I've loved talking to you. Super fun. What's next?
Game time!
Will you count us down?
Yes.
All right.
3, 2, 1, go!
Welcome to Kids Church. What's good? What's happening? How you guys doing? You guys good? Hey, that's what I'm talking about. You guys are amazing. Hope you guys know that. Well, guys, I thought it'd be cool to do something different. I'm going to be playing a game called 50 Questions, alright? So basically what's going to happen is I'm going to hop on IG, which is basically code name, you know, nickname for Instagram. And I'm going to be asked some questions. And I'm going to answer them. You know, I thought it might be cool for you all to get to know me a little bit better, all right? You ready? I'm ready. You ready? I'm ready. All right. Let's do it. All right, guys, let's play. First question. One word that describes me. Creative. All right, let's see. Favorite thing you own? Y'all, I still have a Game Boy Color, man. I'm really proud of that. That's probably my favorite thing I own. What question will we have now? Favorite pastime? Playing Fortnite or Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and beating you guys.
Victory!
Here. How many pets do you have? I currently don't have any pets, but I think I had 5 dogs growing up. My favorite dog that I ever had was Coco. She was a baby pit.
We now take a quick commercial break.
What do you call strawberries playing the guitar? A jam session.
All right, good questions. Let's see what else we got. Super strength or super speed? Y'all already think I'm pretty fast, so maybe super strength. All right, here you go. And stop. What was a childhood fear? Man, y'all, I was afraid of the dark, man. I still kinda am. Pineapple on pizza? Absolutely. Pineapple on pizza. Y'all, if you don't like pineapple on pizza, I just don't know. Come on. Go and stop. Where are you from? If you guys don't know where I'm from by now, I'm from Houston, Texas. Born and raised. Yeah, yeah. All right, y'all, this is my last one. Come on, give me a good one. Ideas for baby names? I think a great name for a baby would be MJ. That's a great name for a baby.
We now take a quick commercial break.
Oh no! Only one fry!
Alright guys, well that was 50 questions. I hope you guys enjoyed that, especially the commercial breaks. Yes, I enjoyed answering those questions, and I hope you guys got to know me a little bit better. Well, you guys enjoy the rest of Kids Church, all right? Until next time, peace.
What's up, everybody? You guys know what time it is. It is birthday time. If you guys don't know who I am, my name is MJ. And if you also don't know that whenever I'm here, we celebrate with DJ Air Horns. So let's get right into it. On January 23rd, happy birthday to my man, Maxwell. We got some DJ Air Horns for you, buddy. Here we go. Hey, guys, on January 24th, happy birthday to Brooklyn, Everly, Gabriel, and Adam. We got some DJ Air Horns for you guys. Here we go. Yep. On January 25th, happy birthday to Ava. DJ Air Horns for you. Yeah. And then last but not least, on January 28th, happy birthday to my man, Finley, and to the amazing Samantha. DJ Air Horns for you guys. Hey, that's what I'm talking about. And if I didn't say your name, happy birthday to you. You know we got some DJ Air Horns for you. Here we go. Yep. And guys, how we celebrate birthdays here is that we're going to sing the very last line. And we're going to do it regular because I feel like we haven't done it the regular way in a very long time. Are you guys ready? Oh my goodness. You're not ready. Are you guys ready? Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Come on. Hey, that's what I'm talking about. All right, I guess we're... Nope! DJ Air Horns! Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Love you guys so much. Again, happy birthday, and enjoy the rest of service. Awesome.
In Kids Church, when we talk about kingdom, we use the word out. For us, that means that we participate in what God is doing here and around the world by reaching out with His love in word and deed. One of the ways we do that in Kids Church is by supporting kids from around the world. This is Sarah. We have loved being her friend since 2011 when she was 7. Sarah lives in Uganda with her parents and 3 sisters. Her birthday is September 14th. She is 16. Sarah spends the most time with her father. She celebrates her birthday by drinking soda and juice. Sarah likes to hear the drums at her church and listen to the radio because it gives her good news. Her favorite subject in school is history. During the COVID pandemic, Sarah has been doing home-based learning, and her village received sanitation stations so they can wash their hands. When Jesus was asked, "What is the most important commandment?" this is what he said: "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul. Love him with all your mind. This is the first and most important commandment, and the second is like it. Love your neighbor as you love yourself." Sponsoring these children is one of the ways that Kids Church has chosen to live out this instruction from Jesus. Our prayer will always be that through our gifts, each child will experience the love and compassion and care of God.
We're thankful for Sarah. She lives in Uganda, and we're thankful that God can watch over her.
We pray that she gets the COVID vaccines and her village soon. We pray that she gets everything that she needs. Jesus' name, amen.
Feeling down, you pick me up.
Sing, oh, 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 oh.
And when my heart is feeling emptied out, you fill my cup.
Sing it out now, oh, oh, oh.
I just wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I just wanna say thank you for the way you love me.
Here we go, verse 2.
I'm grateful for the way you've been a friend to me.
Sing, oh, oh, oh.
And even in the deepest, darkest night, you help me see.
Sing it out now, oh, oh, oh.
I just wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I wanna say thank you for the way you love me. I just wanna say thank you.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go. Coming for the heart that holds on, a glorious light beyond all compare. And there will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, we'll live to know you here on the earth.
Hey guys, welcome back to our Kids Church family experience. I cannot wait to see what God has in store for us today. This month, we're talking all about what it looks like for God to help us grow in responsibility. And today is no different. You see, responsibility is showing you can be trusted with what is expected of you. We have learned a lot about responsibility. We have learned what it means to love God and to love others, share what you have, and to work hard with all your heart. God has been teaching us some amazing things so far, and He has more in store for us today. But before we get into our lesson, I think we should play our next challenge in our board game. If you're ready, say I'm ready on the count of three. One, two, three. Hey, all right. You guys sound ready for the next challenge in our board game, Kids Church Island. If we can complete today's challenge, we can move past the woods and move on to the next section of our game. Today's challenge is a treasure hunt. For our challenge, I'm going to give you clues for pieces of treasure that you'll find around your house. Once I give you the clue, you'll have 30 seconds to find the clue and bring it back to where you're sitting. Once you find all the pieces of treasure, the challenge will be complete. Are you ready? If you're ready, say, I'm ready. Okay, awesome. Let's go. Our first clue is, got a stuffed or runny nose? Or maybe some dust on your shoes? No need to cry. Simply hunt for a box of... All right, you've got 30 seconds. Go! Good work, y'all. I hope you found a box of tissues. All right, let's move on to our second clue. One hand is longer than the other, but you don't need a doctor. It has numbers 1 through 12. It's time to find a... All right, go! Nice. Looks like you guys found the clock. Time for clue number three. Here we go. Getting a little hungry? Search for this round item. A meal fits on this. Go! Good job. Y'all found the plate. Okay, here we go. Here is our last clue. Need to wash your hand without water? Maybe you need a bottle of... All right, go! That one was a little harder. It was hand sanitizer. Good job, guys. Once again, round of applause for all of your effort there. Awesome, awesome, awesome. We finished our challenge. Good job. Now we get to move ahead on our board game. It looks like we made it through the woods and into a desert. That one will be our final challenge. It's all or nothing next week. Think we can make it to the finish? I don't know. We'll have to come back and see. So let's jump into our story today and see what we can learn.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, Stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verses 14 through 30.
When Jesus wanted to share of truth with the people that followed him, he often would tell a parable, a story.
Here is what the kingdom of heaven will be like.
These parables used everyday situations to help people think and understand God's truth for themselves. One day in Jerusalem, Jesus wanted to share a story with his followers. If he told that same story today, it might sound something like this. There once was a man who created the world's most amazing energy bar.
Just one bite and I feel like I could leap tall buildings in a single bound. What is even in these?
If I told you, I'd have to leave you stranded on top of Mount Everest.
The man did such a good job of selling the energy bars, he soon became wealthy. Then one day, he got on a Zoom call with three of his top employees.
Zane, Ren, Murray.
Yes, sir.
Right here.
Murray.
Says he's here.
I don't hear him.
Start your audio, Murray.
Oh, hey, just, you know, I was finishing the movie.
I've called you together for an important purpose. I'm going offline.
You're what?
Completely screen-free. I'm going to travel the world for a while. Hike Everest, cross the Sahara, dive down to the Mariana Trench, miles beneath the ocean. All fueled by my energy bar, of course.
Dude, that is far out.
Literally.
The rich man had carefully studied his employees and knew what they could handle.
While I'm gone, I'm leaving you in charge of my money. Zane, I'm sending you an encrypted key to access my gold account with 5,000 credits.
Oh, excellent.
Ren, here's an encrypted key to access my silver account with 2,000 credits.
I'm on it.
Murray, check your inbox for an encrypted key to my bronze account with 1,000 credits.
That's it.
That's it. I'm going off the grid.
Immediately, Zane accessed the money from the gold account and put that money to work. He hired scientists and designers to create a suction shoe that would keep a rock climber from falling.
I call it the fly shoe.
The fly shoe sold as nearly as fast as the energy bar. Zane soon made his money back and more. Ren, meanwhile, made excellent use of the money in the silver account.
What does every adventurer need besides fuel and shoes? A friend.
So Ren invented a robotic hamster that could travel anywhere an explorer can go, from the highest of mountains to the deepest ocean trench. Soon, robotic adventure hamsters sold as fast as toilet papers. So that left only Murray, who sat looking at the bronze account on his computer screen.
Only 1,000? It's like he expects me to mess it up. Well, I'll show him. Ha!
So Murray took the money out in coins and stashed them in a giant bag. Then late one night, dug a hole in his backyard, stashed the bag inside, and covered it right back up.
Great. Now all I have to do is go back inside and watch Netflix.
After a very long time, the rich man returned from the wilds.
Ah, electricity, internet. I have returned to the grid. Please accept my meeting invite.
Zane and Ren hopped on the call immediately. Murray took a little longer.
Start your audio, Murray.
Oh yeah. There it is.
I'm excited to see how you've handled my money, Zane.
Through sales of the fly shoe, I've added 5,000 more credits to your gold account.
Well done, good and faithful employee. You've been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share my happiness. Now, Ren.
My adorable traveling robotic hamsters have earned 2,000 more credits for your silver account.
Well done, good and faithful employee. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share my happiness. Murray.
Hold on.
Murray reached down and held up a muddy sack. He spilled the coins across the desk.
How much is that?
1,000 credits.
That's what I gave you.
Yeah, well, I knew you're a tough businessman. You make money even where you haven't worked for it. I didn't want you getting mad, so I just buried the money. See? It's all safe.
Murray offered a weak smile, but instead of smiling back, the rich man went red in the face.
You lazy man. If you knew I can make money even when I haven't worked for it, you should have at least kept my money in the bank where it would have earned a little bit.
Sure.
The rich man turned to his personal assistant and ordered.
Take Murray's credits and give them to Zane, who already has 10,000 credits. Oh, and take Murray off my payroll immediately.
The message of Jesus' story was clear. If you are responsible for what you were given, you'll be given more. If you wasted it, you end up with nothing.
Have you ever heard of the word talent before? We often think a talent is something that we're good at, like playing soccer or playing an instrument. But back when Jesus was telling this story, a talent was a unit of money, kind of like a dollar. And in this story, it was equal to what you would get for 20 years worth of work. Can you imagine how much money that would be? Today, that would be almost $700,000. That's a 7 with 5 zeros behind it. That's a lot of money. The first thing we see in our story is that the owner is a generous giver. God is the same way. He's a generous giver. In John 3:16, it says, God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son. Anyone who believes in him will not die, but have eternal life. The key word there is gave. It's clear God is generous because he gave his life. This generous owner in the story gives the employees a huge gift. They get the chance to make a difference in the world around them. They didn't choose what they got, but they did get to choose what they do with what the owner gave them. They could choose to use them or to bury them. What was true for them is also true for you and for me. God has given each of you a talent, and it's our job to manage them responsibly. When you're responsible and use wisely whatever God has given you, then he knows he can trust you with more. It reminds me of our memory verse for this month. Suppose you can be trusted with something very little, then you can also be trusted with something very large. Luke 16:10. The owner said, "Well done, good and faithful servants," to the servants who managed their talents well. He saw that they could be trusted with a little bit, and the owner gave them more. My hope for us is that God would say that to us too. Well done, good and faithful servants. We can be responsible and make the most of what has been given to us. And that's what we need to remember today. Make the most of what you've been given. When you hear the word talent, you can think it's just our skills or what we're good at, but it's more than that. It's everything that God gives us. Our time, our energy, our family, our friends, our experiences, our allowance. It's literally everything that God gives us. He wants us to make the most of what he's given us. We didn't have to do a single thing to earn our talents, but he doesn't want us to waste what he's given us. Instead, he wants us to use what we have to show his love to others. So what will you do with your talents? It can feel a little overwhelming sometimes with knowing how to use our talents. Maybe you feel like you're not old enough, or perhaps you think if you use your talent, someone might make fun of you, or you might think that it's too hard or takes too much work. What we learn from the story is that everyone is given a talent. It's up to you what you do with it. Here are some next steps for you. Maybe you don't know what you've been given. Ask your friends and parents to see if they've noticed what you're good at. Perhaps it's building a giant Lego tower or being creative by building something in Minecraft. Or maybe you're good at telling funny jokes or how you're great at playing a sport. Or it could be a number of things, like you enjoy helping people when they're in need, or writing a cool story, being friendly, cooking, baking, or cheering someone up when they've had a hard day. Whatever you've been given, you can use it to honor God, because God is so generous and gracious to us. So let's not waste any more time. Let's use everything we have to worship God. Let's start by looking at Jesus, who made the most of his time with people. He showed love to everyone and helped them understand what's most important to God. Let's follow the example he gave us and live a life that honors him. Before we close, let's spend some time talking with our families about what God has given us and how we can make the most of it. But before we do, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gifts and talents that you've given us. We praise you for being generous. God, would you help us this week as we learn more about you and learn how we can use our talents. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks, guys.
Friends, we hope you enjoyed this week's Kids Church Family Experience. We are thankful for each and every one of you, and we are praying for your families. I think you're going to like this week's riddle. Ready? What gets bigger when more is taken away? A hole. Bye, guys.